coward shy away, come to take the throne. To conquer world powers, bring Jacob home. I'm quarterbacking like Jake DeLong, like Mount Rushmore, I got a face of stone.
Praise the Prince, Yahweh, Bashim Yahweh. That's all praise to the Most High God, in the name of His only begotten Son of the world, ignorantly called Jesus Christ.
Liar.
And I'm glad to be out here with my brethren. So look at the state of Israel.
Are too afraid to stand.
Give me Jeremiah.
Get out of here, bro.
But these people have revolting and rebellious heart.
They're what?
Revolting and rebellious heart.
That's what she wanted, man. She got a revolting and rebellious heart. Go ahead.
They are revolted and gone.
They're what?
Revolted and gone.
This woman is revolted and gone, bro. Sis.
You come up here with self-control. You've been yelling since you got here. What do you mean self-control?
You're a hypocrisy, people, bro. What you
got? This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 6, verse 30. Reprobate silver.
What is a reprobate silver?
I'm looking for murder.
What, bro? What do you even want?
What
do you want? What do you want?
Is that you?
What are you looking for?
You got the balls to do it?
What are you looking for?
Reprobate silver shall men call them, because Yahweh have rejected them.
What happened to him?
The Lord has rejected them.
The Most High God has rejected them. That's what it is. That's why you come here smoking cigarettes. What do you want? What do you want?
It's the book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 14.
Bring it out!
The sower sowed the word.
What?
The sower sowed the word.
Now you got battle axe and Sicarii out here trying to sow the word. Trying to put the word out in the airwaves so Israel can wake up, and look what happens, man. Look what happens.
And these are they by the wayside where the word is sown?
That's the people out here.
On the wayside where the word is sown, and what? But when they have heard, Satan cometh immediately.
Who come?
Satan cometh immediately.
Everybody, who is this?
Satan cometh immediately and taking away the word that was sown in their hearts.
That's what she's doing, man. You can't even really teach out here with this. You can't even talk to Israel and have a decent conversation with Israel without Jake being bugged out, man.
That's right.
Can you have a conversation? Can you have a conversation?
You won't win.
Bring it out!
Can you have a conversation?
Bring it out!
Let's have a conversation.
No! Enough talk! Action! You want to sit there and say?
You should have fight a group of men.
What
God damn!
You're not coming out here.
It's the book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 14. The sower sowed the word, and these are they by the wayside. When the word is sown, and when they have heard, Satan cometh immediately.
Okay,
Satan cometh immediately.
Satan cometh immediately.
You know what?
We're moving on.
Somebody
please block her out. Just put it over
and
there.
Attack.
Do something.
It's spiritual warfare.
I can't do it.
Is this your war?
Give me John.
This is your war.
16.
This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 26, verse 14. A silent and loving woman is a gift of the Lord.
What kind of woman?
Silent and loving woman is a gift from the Lord.
That's not a gift of the Lord. That's a curse of the Lord.
That's right.
Matter of fact, literally, because Deuteronomy 28, was that 55, 57, we're talking about tender and delicate woman? That's a curse of the Lord.
And there's nothing much worth as a mind well instructed.
She does not have a mind well instructor. Bug the hell. This is about to go into something, bro. Give me John 3:16. Because I want to go into this, bro. Because just like that devil, I forgot that white devil that we had to deal with earlier, who that army vet, right? He said he did it for us. He brought up John 3:16, man. Let's talk about John 3:16.
This is the book of St. John, chapter 3, verse 16.
Bring it out,
for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
A regular Christian's breakdown is that is, God sent Jesus to die for everybody. That doesn't work with the rest of the, that doesn't harmonize with the rest of the scriptures. There's no hermeneutics with that. So let's look at other scriptures and see if you can apply that same knowledge, right? Give me Exodus chapter 23, where it talks about the covenant, the blood that Moses sprinkled. Yeah, go ahead.
It's the book of Hebrews, chapter 9 and verse 15. And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament.
He is the mediator of the New Testament. That's talking about Christ, right? Go ahead.
That by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the First Testament.
So what?
What's up?
For the redemption of the transgressions that were under the First Testament.
He died for the redemptions, the redemption of sins that were under the First Testament. Now, everybody wasn't under the First Testament. Not every person in the world was in the First Testament. So let's see who was a part of that First Testament.
And Moses, this is the book of Exodus, chapter 24, verse 2. And Moses alone shall come near the Lord, but they shall not come nigh. Neither shall the people go up with him. And Moses came and told the people all the words of the Lord and all the judgment. And all the people answered with one voice and said, all the words which the Lord have said will we do.
That's what Israel did in the wilderness. All the words that Moses read unto us, we said we will do. That's part of the first covenant. Go ahead.
Verse 4. And Moses wrote all the words of the Lord and rose up early in the morning and built an altar under the hill and 12 pillars according to the 12 tribes of Israel.
Now Moses built 12 pillars for the 12 tribes of Israel, right? Go ahead. Context, Israel.
And he sent young men of all the children of Israel, which offer burnt offerings and sacrifice peace offerings of oxen unto the Lord. And Moses took half of the blood and put it on in basins, and half the blood he sprinkled on the altar. And he took the book of the covenant and...
Book of the what?
Covenant.
Book of the covenant. This is about the first covenant. Go ahead. First Testament.
And read in the audience of the people, and they said, all that the Lord has said will we do, and be obedient. Okay, and Moses took the blood and sprinkled it on the people.
Sprinkled it on who?
The people.
Contextually, that's talking about the Israelites. That's 12 pillars. That's 12 pillars that Moses built for the children of Israel. He sprinkled the blood of the first covenant on them. Go ahead.
And said, behold, the blood of the covenant.
Blood of the what?
The blood of the covenant which the Lord have made with you. Concerning all these words.
All these words, that's talking about the law. We agreed to that, so the blood got sprinkled upon us, and we were enjoined in the first testament or first covenant. Now let's read this again. Go back to Hebrews.
It's the book of Hebrews, chapter 9 and verse 15.
Bring it out!
And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament by the means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the First Testament.
Christ died for the redemptions of the sins that were under the First Testament or First Covenant. Who was under that? Israel. Only Israel. So John 3:16 can't literally mean everybody. Or guess what? That's going to conflict. The scriptures will conflict. Christians want to make the Bible a freaking schizophrenic book. They want to make our God a schizophrenic God. They want to just make him be a deadbeat dad. You have to believe you want the Most High God to be a deadbeat dad, because you don't want nothing to happen with this. Where to sign it? You want the Most High God to be a deadbeat dad to forgive this. There has to be a payment for this. And matter of fact, what about all the prophecies about it? What about all the prophecies about Israel coming back? What about all the prophecies about Israel? Take me to Jeremiah 30 and 16. What about this? Jeremiah 30 and 16. You can get a priest. Yeah, go to Jeremiah. Because what about the prophecies, bro?
Yeah. I can resist.
What are you here for? It's funny as hell. You doing that with a cigarette in your hand? What difference does that make? I got this to reach people. You got that to kill yourself. Yeah, so yeah. You're going to reach people in heaven after you're dead from cancer.
That's right.
You're going to die, yeah. I said, you're deaf scriptures. Go ahead. I don't care. You mean Isaiah 28. 28.
I'm so cool.
No, bro. I want to teach a lesson, bro. I know, bro. Isaiah 28.
The
book of Isaiah, chapter 28 and verse 15. Because he has said, we have made a covenant with death. Made a covenant with death. And all the rest of Israel who wants to smoke cigarettes and be a bug out like this woman has made a covenant with death, man. The Most High God's gonna put your ass to death. It's all right though, because you want to sit here and reject his voice. You want to sit here and scoff against the people who's trying to raise you up out of this position. That's right. So you get put to death. Your ass is gonna get put to death. Because you have sinned, we have made a covenant with death, and with hell are we with the at agreement. And hell, did she say, is it really going to get with hell are we at agreement? Hell are we in agreement? That's what she is, man. She's in agreement with death. She wants to die. She wants to get put underground, man. That's right, exactly. Read it again. Because ye have said, we have made a covenant with death. And with hell are we at agreement?
That's right.
When the whole flowing scourge shall pass through, it shall not come unto us. For we have made lies our refuge.
What she does, she made lies our refuge.
You think we're false prophets? We're false prophets. We read the Bible. It's on the point we come straight out of the Bible.
Are we false prophets?
That's the issue. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 8. That's all it boils down to. We're false prophets. Check this out. We're false prophets to come out of the Bible. Wait a minute. If you despise us, you despise the word. If you despise the word, you despise the Most High God.
This is the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 8. He therefore that despiseth,
he or she that despiseth not men,
but God, who have also given unto us his Holy Spirit.
Given unto us his Holy Spirit to teach the word. Oh, there it goes. No, there it goes, bro. There it goes. She loves the white man. That's what it boils down to. We did.
That was last year.
What about today?
Today. Get off the dead lazy butt and take this
water. My dead lazy. Give me 2 Corinthians 10.
Guess what?
She says this, but she never does that.
That's the so-called black woman in America, man. So-called black man come out here, Latino man, do work. Still lazy.
We're still lazy, bro. This side of our oppressor, bro.
Coward.
This is the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 10, verse 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds.
The council of what?
Of strongholds.
Cast down strongholds. We're not physically out here trying to take the White House.
Right.
How are we going to take the White House?
Right.
That's literally like saying, go kill yourself.
That's what she just told me.
You basically told us to go kill ourselves by going to go take the White House.
That's what she
just
said.
Okay.
You got the cut? Bring that cut back out. We're gonna knock the dust off of that scripture.
Alright, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into the captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Okay. Verse 6. And having in a readiness to revenge our disobedience when your obedience is Okay. That's why I went. That's why I started it. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Weapons of our warfare are not carnal, man.